time. Look at those fins. nice shoebox. Can't hardly hear it run. I like that one. Oh, I remember that one from 2019. Where's the Pink Panther? Oh yeah, he's still riding. I got the stink eye. Famous garlic fries.
Thank you.
prettiest car I believe I've ever seen. And I've seen a bunch of them. I'm such a stalker. Wow. Flatheads forever. Oh, he's got a... Man, rocking that Columbia rear end, too. That is cool, man. The T-Hot Rod with a Columbia 2-speed rear and a built flathead V8. Man. Now, that's a celebrity right there. I love that. Too cool for school, Bo. Bo. Why say Bo? Whatever. Nice. Here in the land of 10,000 lakes, 10,000 classic cars. Got a little stuck valve or something. She's fixable. Smith? Huh? So what do we got going on here, Bob?
What we got going is a friend of mine who's camped around the corner bought this car because he needed parts for his 51 Chevrolet. So he took all the good parts off there. And when I talked to him, I said, what are you doing with what's left? And he said, I can get $75 at the scrapyard, so I'm scrapping it. So I said, well, I'll give you $75 for the car. And the bottom of the car was pretty rusty. And my daughter happened to like the movie Toy Story. And so the wood theme. And then one time we were someplace and we talked about having wood on cars. And she made a comment, well, that's a fake woody because that's paper. That's not real wood. And I said, yeah, that's right. That's not real wood. So we decided we'd try to make a woody out of the car and incorporate the Toy Story image with it.
Okay.
Oh my gosh!
All right, I may never get out of it.
You are tiny,
but I fit. To ride on this thing, man.
Yeah, like
that. Yeah, I always want to ride in a Woody. Snelling, it's been going down for many decades here in St. Paul. That's the drag. It's about 5 o'clock, June the 19th, Saturday, 2021. We're at MSRA Back to the 50s. You're watching Samspace81. This is a real special show. It's good to be back. Look at that Mercedes. Wow. A lot of beautiful iron out here. Iron, fiberglass, steel, aluminum, chrome, hot metal. Cool, I like that.
Bye.
friend's truck.
Thank you.
like these big old cars. This is a Rio. Dual mount spares. That was an expensive car. Look at the wood wheels. Let's look inside it. Oh, it looks all correct. I can already tell. Look at that big back seat. Personal ashtrays back there. Full gauges. We got temp gauge in the dash with the Mercury on it. Turn signals. This thing's nice. Beautiful car. This is when your trunk was a trunk. 1933 is right before they come out with a trunk back. It's got a hump in it, about 35. It's your history lesson for today. Back to the 50s is probably my favorite, if not one of my favorite events that I go to. It's just so impressive. 12 entrances, 10,000 plus pre-1964 classics. We're walking around on Friday morning, very early. Not even 8 o'clock yet. Sounds good. Cam flathead in it, I bet you.
Thank you.
I like your style.
Thank you.
Cool.
And with the Lincoln engine, they only made 377 sunroof cars.
The Lincoln engine. What's it got, a 430?
Yeah.
The big motor.
Yeah, 59 and 60 to 430 for the NASCAR.
A rare option. Get you a history lesson out here. That's cool. Look at that. Wow. It looks just as nice as it looks in this camera, I'm going to tell you. I can just spot quality, folks. I had a car inspection business before I went all in on my YouTube channel, and I'm telling you right now, this is a quality car. Reeks of quality. Done. Beautiful stainless. I'm not going to crawl under it, but I'm guessing it's got red oxide floors and a powder coated frame. Original invoice, photocopy, $35.50. He ordered it new, 1960. I buy a lot of my old shirts on eBay from the 70s, 60s. Thank you. I think it's flat out. No, not really. That's cool. Yeah, I hear you, man. Jerry's ride. Always hot, especially when the sun hits it. Thank you. Look at the design on the fenders. The way they French into the hood. sounds better than these flatheads. And they look better too.
You too.
Lincoln to a Mercury. That is an animal.
Roll down window.
Zephyr and that Cadillac, so they had set an F. I was trying to say fastback. Cool, driver quality Nomad. Not a trailer queen. Having too much fun.
I know.
Up higher than a big lot, if you're wondering. livery. I sure know my rides. Dealers used a handful of those to display the new Y-block V8 when it came out. Yeah, some hot iron coming by. The Crestline Skyliner. It's got the glass roof. Flexi. Sitting on a Suburban frame. Thank you. current situation, it has not rained, just overcast. About 6:30 in the evening Saturday, we're hanging it out, still hanging in there. I actually see a little sun breaking through on that end. Maybe we'll get to see a sunset together. One of the soft top. Soft top was optional. Good looking. That's cool, man. I had a roll top too. Thank you. like alike. How are you? Doing great. Seen them being cars.
Huh? Samspace81?
That's me. Get them both. Get this one and that one. It's got a CNI.
Yep.
I didn't even know you could get that with the Olds.
Oh, yeah.
So what is the difference in a Super 88 and a 98? Is this just a well-optioned car?
Super 88 is got the trim of a 98, but a 10-inch smaller body. So that 88 Super 88 is about 10 inches shorter. 98.
I didn't know that.
And it shows up in the rear wheel well.
Oh, the way it's more spaced in the back a little?
Yep. You look at a 98, it comes up, and then it's flat, and then it goes down. Whereas this one comes up, and it's got a constant curve going up.
Excellent. So this was a sportier car, basically.
Yeah. The 98's, like, you know, it's a bigger car. And of course, in 57, the bigger the better.
Yes. So tell me a little story about it. What did you restore this car?
I did. I bought it. It was a shell from the cowl to the taillights. There were no top. There was no interior. There were no floors. There was no drivetrain, front fenders, or anything. So I bought this car and two parts cars. And out of the three of them, I put this car together.
You did an incredible job with it. How long did it take you to do it? Did you do a lot of the work yourself on it?
I did everything except upholster the seats and plate the chrome.
Wow, you're out there sanding on it, sweating, wiring it.
Oh, sure.
Did you use a longboard on it?
Oh, I had to.
Yeah. Wow. What's your name again?
My name's Bill.
Bill. Thank you, sir.
Yep.
Appreciate you bringing it out.
Please. Now he's making a video, boys, behave.
Yeah.
Don't be saying any curse words.
We're going to take Sam to the titty bar.
I've never been to one.
I better shut up.
I always felt like I'd get in trouble.
Yeah, me and my big ball.
You might want to cut that out.
Now I got to do the parade wave.
Oh, yeah, now you got to do the parade wave. We should have you sitting up on the back seat.
Yeah, you're the star of the whole thing. Look, he's got his hand doing it.
They're the, our crew.
Yeah, we kind of got the Friday foot traffic today, or yesterday, the Saturday foot traffic. Everybody thought it was going to rain out today.
Yeah.
Yeah.
And now nobody's really here. It's usually so many people you can't drive around.
Yeah.
I see some tents right there.
It rides so smooth and quiet.
Oh, does it?
It really does. Know it's running. My dad had a Corvette shop, and we'd work on them, and I was looking at that clock. We'd always sand the points on them clocks and get them to work again.
Yep, I need to do that. That seems to always work. If you oil them a little bit, and sand the points.
How many years, Bill, we've been coming to this show? I lost track.
Oh, geez.
It's 40.
Yeah, since the mid-70s.
Yeah. Well, the first ones were over at Midway parking lot.
Yeah.
Y'all talking about the show?
Yeah.
You've been coming here since the 70s?
Yeah.
Cool. You said they used to have them at another place?
Yeah, they were over in a big shopping mall. And it outgrew that, what, 2 years?
Yeah. And then it was just kind of small here at the fairgrounds. It was kind of over by the 4-H building, but it was kind of small.
When they had the racetrack, we even had cars down there. Swap meet and everything went down there.
Yeah, that racetrack, that was a great venue. When they had the racetrack, we had car shows. The car show would be in the center of the racetrack. It was off grass. And the paved part of the racetrack, the blacktop part, was a swap.
Yes.
Yeah.
Is this a closed down track?
Yeah, it's gone now.
Yeah.
And there was a tunnel you drove through to get
off. I worked volunteer, down in there, and it was so cool to watch the cars come out of that tunnel.
Yeah.
They come out of a tunnel at the Daytona Speedway I filmed at a couple of months ago, first time there, and that was cool. You could hear them echoing through there, like the infield tunnel.
So, what's the best show that you've gone to?
Oh, man, probably this one. That's hard to say, because they all bring something different.
Yeah.
And every time I'm at one, I'll think, oh, this is the best one ever.
Yeah.
I thought that when I was in Modesto here a couple of weeks ago for Back to the 50s, for American Graffiti.
Okay.
50th.
So, have you been to the Woodward Cruise?
Yes.
Is
I think
that a
I've
good
been
show?
There 3 or 4 years.
Okay.
It's a big one. It's kind of spread out.
Uh-huh.
There's several little shows in all the communities.
Okay.
But yeah, it's huge. All the regular traffic kind of mixes with the classics. They try to restrict it.
You're a street over this way, aren't you, Joe?
Yeah, but you gotta go the one way.
Yeah, I gotta go straight down here.
Yeah.
Explaining to the folks how everybody sits in front of their cars when it gets late on Saturday and watches everybody cruise.
Yep.
Yeah. Long as they don't do burnouts or shoot flames,
mm-hmm.
they're okay. soon as they do that, one of the golf carts will catch them. You ever go to James Dean Memorial?
I just heard about it and I want to go to it. I've never been. I found it online, you know, looking around, but I've never been to that one.
I've gone to it in the past probably 5 times.
Really?
And then they have flame throwing contests and all that stuff.
Cool.
And there's another show there too at the same time, Ducktail Run.
Okay, hadn't heard of that one.
Yeah.
Have you ever been to the Iola, Wisconsin show?
Yeah.
I'm going to that this year. I've never been to that one.
Okay.
That's more swappy than it
is. Is it?
Yeah.
Back to the 50s, Samspace81. Thanks for tuning in.
These are two of my friend's cars I was just riding with. Awesome stuff. MSRA car. Yeah, cool, man.
the minute he was born, he didn't look like any of the names that he comes to me.
Thank you.
Oh, that real pretty green one there?
Mm-hmm. It's basically about the same color, but we've got the patina.
And yours is a Fleet Master?
That is correct.
Or Fleet, is that right, Fleet Master?
Yep.
That old girl.
Just about in the middle, but I ran into sand.
Man, I want to open the door so bad, but I'm not going to touch it. You know what I mean?
Yeah. Even if it's unlocked, it's like,
they're just itching to open. Be opened.
I agree.
There's a guy out here with like a 29 Model A like this truck, yeah. And it was idling, and he was all into it. His grandpa built them.
I didn't always have one actually. It was just like sitting there.
Yeah,
like
that's it. Look at the old cooler. That's cool.
I mean, myself, I noticed that.
Yeah, I'm always sending my buddy 40 shots. He likes 40s. That is a nice blue. Nice and straight. Thank you. worked with them, sold them. They were a 61.
Uh-huh. It'll be 61 years old. Get that stuff ray pop. They may have just took it off and worked it all. It's metal. Oh, even the wheels are cool. Willys hubcaps.
Yeah, you're cooler than all the rental scooters out here in that thing.
They were parked up here, and there was a blue one besides.
I'll go check it out.
Yeah, blue one didn't look close, but...
Is that just the highlights? Thank you.
Got to show that. Maybe somebody will comment, I had a McGurk intake.
Yeah. It's got a whole hodgepodge. Different person.
Yeah.
Deluxe originally.
Yeah.
And they took the deluxe and they gave you plans on a build a 100 mile an hour sports car. Using a 39 or 32 through 39 Ford Deluxe.
When you leave, watch
for this.
Get away.
Yeah. Get the kids off the street.
Yeah.
I used to work for a classic dealership and I did all the marketing, and it reminds me of a Lotus that they had. They had a small block Chevy and a kit, you know, kit.
Sure.
But similar design.
Yeah.
Just hairy fast.
Yeah.
You know.
Probably a Caterham Super 7.
It was like that.
Yeah.
You ever go to that Iola?
Mason jar there.
I see that little vacuum canister on top.
Yep.
Got you an oil filter. That was an option, I believe.
And the convenient glass bottle here for the fuel. It's a great place to put that.
What's it like driving it?
It's scary.
Scary.
It shifts fine. Anyone could, I mean, even myself who's not inclined completely to the gas and clutch ratio. I mean, you can hop in there, you can drive it, and like I said, the main thing is, you know, it's blowing through, you know, at least 5 quarts every 20 miles, so
you'll get it sorted out.
Yeah, there are always a
good bones.
Very slow climb to the top of plastic. You know,
yep.
It'll take time.
So. It takes a lot of patience.
Indeed, so.
I know you can do it. Adam, it's a pleasure. Thank you very much, sir.
Appreciate it. You can be sure to check out the rest of Sam's videos as well.
Oh, man. Even got a plug.
Absolutely.
Wood green. But whoever had it before was a smoker. I love original ads and stuff like that.
Me too. Super highway.
Never seen before. And I was thinking along
this is Adam's father. Introduce you here.
And
what's your name?
My name is Jamie Jensen, and this is Adams and ours, 48. And when we bought it, we thought this was a really unique feature, and we thought, like you were thinking, maybe it's air shocks. But what it is when you go in, get your oil changed, check your tires, there's a hose on the inside of here, and this attaches to your spare tire, so you don't have to adjust the air pressure on your tire. You just put the tire gauge on there and fill it. Your spare tire inside.
First time I've seen that. That's
so
interesting.
Basically, yeah. Back then, you
very
know,
cool.
They just do basic service, you know, when they were going around filling up everything. They just hook up their hose, fill that up, and then they, you know, I heard that, you know, they filled up your washer fluid or whatever, and just a little tidy stuff like that. Stuff like that. Sad that we don't do stuff like that in the modern days.
Right.
And I keep forgetting to look on other 48s to see if anyone else has that. I don't know if it was the owner that thought of that, did that on their own, or an extra thing. Like, I hope later he'll appreciate that. I think that's cool. I love that kind of stuff.
What's that?
The whole engine just kind of kitty-bompus.
I guess that's why they called it a slant six, because it's kind of slanted over. I never really thought about that. Now that you mentioned it,
yeah,
you know, they call them a slant six.
Yeah.
Maybe that's because of the position in the engine bay.
I thought that was just a term, but
I did too.
I guess it really is slanted. the great part about like cars like this that you don't see very often is people that have them. I like that they put a target on it. So you know what, you know, where to go for.
Turnpike cruiser. Got the honeycomb wheels on it. It's different. love it. Stunning.
That's so cool.
Didn't it?
I love the Duke of Earl.
Thank you.
Hello. Excuse me, ma'am. Gas in it. I smell it.